Good morning, everyone. Dear all the participants, I welcome you all on the second day of online workshop on nutrient management options for boosting organic agriculture. On the first day, Dr. A.K. Sharma, former professor head, Department of Vegetable Science, Dr. Y.S. Parmar University, delivered his talk on organic farming in India status and concerns. And in evening session, Dr. D.V. Singh, Professor Entomology, SVP, University of Agriculture and Technology, has given his talk on biopesticides as sustainable tools for organic agriculture. Our today's guest is morning session guest is Dr. Sanjay Pathak, Professor and Head Department of Fruit Science, College of Horticulture and Forestry, Acharya Narendra Dev Agriculture University and Technology. The topic he deliver is on-farm management of manures to boost organic agriculture. First, we have to read the resume of Professor Sanjay Pathak sir. As Dr. Sanjay Pathak sir is Professor and Head Fruit Science in College of Horticulture and Forestry College at Acharya Narendra Dev University, Ayodhya. After completion his doctoral degree, he has worked as Assistant Scientist Horticulture at Regional Research Station, Mashobra, Shimla, at Dr. Y.S. Parmar University, Solan. He also worked as Head Research Activities in UPLDC, Lucknow. Professor Pathak has more than 31 years in teaching, research, development, and extension experience in the field of post-harvest technology, watershed development, and organic farming. Moreover, he has supervised 6 PhD and 25 MSc students. He has developed various technologies related to looser land development, organic farming, and post-harvest technology. He is a recipient of several research schemes sponsored by various funding agencies. Professor Pathak has been conferred with 3 awards from various organizations of national level. He has been nominated as Fellow of Indian Society for Horticultural Research Development. His research focuses on post-harvest technology of fruit crops. He has authored 6 booklets. He has published more than 37 research papers in international and national journals of high impact factor. He has also authored various book chapters and manuals. He has organized several seminars, workshops, conferences, and training programs. He has also presented papers and delivered invited talks in various national and international conferences, seminar, training program, refresher course, and received several best paper awards. So I welcome you, sir, and I request you, sir, please go ahead with your presentation.
Thank you, Dr. for giving nice introduction. A very good morning to all of you. I am thankful to Dr. Kashmir Singh, Director and Principal of Mata Gujari College, Fatehgarh Sahib, Dr. Dilip Singh, Head Department of Agriculture, Dr. Sandeep Singh, Assistant Professor, for giving me this opportunity to discuss my thoughts on this platform. Dear participants, faculty members, students, and dear brothers and sisters, now I am going to deliver my topic, that is on farm management of manure to boost organic agriculture. The topic is very much relevant to the Indian culture, that is very close to the Indian culture. Therefore, I would like to speak in both language, Hindi and English, if you have no problem. Sir, next slide, please. Then, if I talk about the organic matter, why organic matter? Because when getting more yield, more income by the inorganic sources by applying of the NPK, then why are we are talking about the organic matter? Because the organic matter is essential for the soil fertility. It maintains good soil, physical condition, soil, that is the soil structure, aeration, and water holding capacity. That is not possible by the inorganic sources. The organic thing means, if you are thinking, there are two or three things. So first of all, I want to introduce the topic. If you, the inorganic farmers, the inorganic thinking people are केवल हम नजदीक का देखते हैं, बहुत दूर का नहीं देख पाते हैं. और जो हमारे ऑर्गेनिक सोर्स के हैं, जो ऑर्गेनिक थिंकिंग के पीपल्स हैं, दे आर कल्टिवेटिंग ऑर्गेनिक एग्रीकल्चर, वो दूर का देखते हैं. जो नजदीक देखते हैं वो केवल, जैसे वी आर कल्टिवेटिंग एग्रोनॉमिकल क्रॉप और हॉर्टिकल्चर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द एनपीके, देन नेक्स्ट ईयर व्हाट हैपेंस, दे आर बाय सॉइल टेस्टिंग, दे आर टेस्टिंग देयर डिफिशियंसी ऑफ द some nutrient like sulfur, it may be the zinc or boron. Next year again he applied this chemical. After 2 or 3 years, then again they are thinking there are a deficiency in the some another nutrient, because they are not thinking for the long duration, but bahut dur tak wo nahi dekh pa rahe hain. Isliye it is very much essential to think, दूर तक देखें और अच्छी तरीके से प्लानिंग करें उस दूर तक जाने के लिए. तो ऑर्गेनिक जो सोच है, ऑर्गेनिक सोच बहुत दूर तक देखी जाती है और पूरे एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड को हम उस हिसाब से मेंटेन करते हैं कि हमें क्या क्या करना है जिससे हमारी यील्ड, हमारी न्यूट्रिशन रिसोर्स उसकी बनी रहे. एंड टूडे वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द इम्यूनिटी. कोरोना इज नॉट डेवलप्ड, द टर्म इज इम्यूनिटी. वाई इम्यूनिटी? बिकॉज यू आर नॉट टेकिंग द फूड ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिक सोर्सेज, दैट इज इनकम्प्लीट फूड. क्योंकि एक जो बीमार माँ है कभी स्वस्थ बच्चे को पैदा नहीं कर सकती. बच्चा तो वैसे ही दिखाई पड़ेगा, उसके दो कान हाथ नाक दोनों रहेंगे, लेकिन वो अंदर बीमार है. इट इज जस्ट लाइक द ग्रेन्स, जो अनहेल्दी अर्थ है उसके कभी भी हम अनहेल्दी सॉइल से कभी भी हम फूड ग्रेन्स को हेल्दी प्राप्त नहीं कर सकते. वो देखने में तो गेहूँ लगेगा, चावल लगेगा, बट इज नॉट कम्प्लीट फूड. दैट इज नॉट कम्प्लीट विद ऑल न्यूट्रिएंट दैट इज अवेलेबल इन द दैट wheat or any grains. It is very much essential to go for an organic agriculture. Otherwise, every time we talk about the immunity, we take vitamin C, we take there are so many medicines that is available in the herb, there are so many herbs that is available in the field. इसलिए बहुत ही आवश्यक है हम organic grow करें. और organic grow करने से हम अगर initial stage से ही इसको खाना चालू करेंगे तो कभी भी हमारे अंदर immunity की कमी नहीं होगी. इन सब बातों को, दिस इज द बेस ऑफ माय टॉपिक कि व्हाई वी आर गोइंग फॉर द ऑर्गेनिक एग्रीकल्चर. द बिकॉज इट मेंटेन द सॉइल स्ट्रक्चर, एरेशन एंड वाटर होल्डिंग कैपेसिटी. इट आल्सो कंटेन्स मोस्ट ऑफ द सॉइल रिजर्व इन नाइट्रोजन एंड लार्ज प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ द अदर न्यूट्रिएंट्स सच एज द फास्फोरस एंड सल्फर दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल बाय द इनऑर्गेनिक मीन्स. ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग इज टारगेटेड टू सस्टेनेबल फार्मिंग, प्रोड्यूसर न्यूट्रिटिव, healthy and pollution free food that is not possible by the inorganic means. It maximizes the use of on farm resources and minimizes the use of off farm resources, and because there are so many things that is available in the on the farm that is manipulated and makes the so many nutrient by organic farming. But in organic farming we are totally dependent on the market, we are totally dependent on the factory. But in case of organic, there is such type of no problem. It is social profit oriented, then profit oriented. In organic farming, entire system, plant, animal, soil, water, to be protected. Next slide, please. Now, what is the organic agriculture? As per the IFOM, a whole system approach based upon a set of process, resulting in a sustainable ecosystem, safe food, good nutrition, animal welfare, and social justice. Organic production, therefore, is more than a system of production that includes or excludes certain inputs. Next, please. What is the objective? To produce healthy, nutritious, and quality food, to maintain and enhance the long-term fertility of soil, to encourage and enhance biological cycle involving microorganisms, soil flora and fauna, to help in soil and water conservation, to minimize all forms of pollution that may result from agricultural practices, to use on-farm resources as far as possible, to maintain genetic diversity, to preserve and enhance traditional and indigenous knowledge of the farming. Next, please. Now, what is the prospect of the organic agriculture? That is the sustainable in the soil health, effective soil moisture conservation, improvement of quality and shelf life of produce, effective land use to utilize interspace of crops for cover cropping and green penury, reduced environment hazards and improved public health, increased farm income through export earning and tapping the elite domestic market, and last one is the rural employment generation. Next, please. The status of organic agriculture. The India holds a unique position among 172 countries participating organic agriculture. It has 6.5 lakh organic producers, 699 processors, 699 exporters, and 7.2 lakh hectares under cultivation. But with merely 0.4% of the total agriculture land under organic cultivation, the industry has a long journey ahead. Our country rank is the 33rd rank in the world in terms of area and organic production. Rank is 88th in the world in terms of ratio of the agricultural land under organic crops, the total farming area. The cultivated area under certification is 3.4 lakh hectare. Main vegetable grown are the okra, brinjal, tomato, potato, onion, and garlic. The total area under cultivation is the 2.8 million hectare. The best part is this: the 17 districts which are utilizing the less than 25 kilogram per hectare of the NPK, and these districts can be converted into the organic agriculture districts. These are situated in 10 districts in the Assam, 5 districts in the Jharkhand, 5 districts in the Himachal Pradesh, 2 districts in the Himachal Pradesh, 8 districts in the Uttar Pradesh, 8 in the Uttaranchal, 7 in Madhya Pradesh, 1 district in the Chhattisgarh, 13 districts in the Rajasthan and northeastern regions. Next, please. This is the basic principle of the agriculture. The first one is the ecology. It maintains the ecology, maintains the health and social justice. That means social justice. And it care our nature, it care our health also. These are the four principles of the organic agriculture. Thank you. Next, please. Types or approaches of organic agriculture. There are so many ways by which we perform the agriculture, we practice the agriculture. That is the natural farming, that is the traditional farming, that is with old farming. There is no do nothing approach. The second one is the ecological agriculture. Tools used for biofertilizer, botanical pesticides, biocontrol agents, stress resistant varieties, vermicompost. There are so many other composting methods. These all are utilized in this cultivation. Rishi Krishi, then Angara, Bhumi Sanskar to make soil fertile. Amrit Pani for the seed treatment, Panchagavya for vegetative and reproductive growth, Biodynamic farming for the nutrient management and for the management of the life energy, HOMA farming that is managed by the HOMA, and zero budget farming. And last one is the permaculture, that is the sustainable design system that applies ecological principles that are found in nature to the development of human settlements. Next one. The crop residues. Then about 50% residues are utilized by the animal feed, and remaining 25 to 30% are burned by the farmers, and only 10 to 15% are utilized by the farmers. That is recycled by the formation of the farmyard manure or so many manures. So, organic manure? The organic manure is derived from biological process like plant, animal, and human residues. The direct impact of organic manure relates to the uptake of organic substances or its decomposition products that affect favorably the growth and yield of plant, indirectly helpful for soil microorganism and their activities, and so will increase the supply of major and minor plant nutrients. Next, please. Bulky organism. There are so many types of the organic manure, that is the FIM, concentrated FIM, compost, green manure, and the FIM are prepared by the two methods. The first one is the inorganic anaerobic, and another one is the aerobic method. The FIM compost is the anaerobic method, and the vermicomposting and biodynamic system of the composting, as well as the nether composting, these are the aerobic method of the composting. Thank you. Next, the FIM, it refers to the well decomposed mixture of dung, urine, farm litter, and leftover or depleted material from refuse or fodder fed to the cattle. These waste products placed in a trench something 6 meters long, 2 meters wide, and 1 meter deep. It may be the varies, the size is according to the farmer or regarding to the producer. Size is not fixed, but the depth of the pit is fixed. It should not be more than 1 meter. And each trench is termed up to the height of about 5 meter above the ground level and plastered over slurry, cow dung, or earth. The material is allowed to decompose undisturbed, takes 4 to 5 months in anaerobic condition, and it takes 4 to 5 to 6 months to total formation of the FIM. It takes very much long time, and this is the very ancient time of the system for making of the FIM. Next, please. Compost. Large quantities of waste product are available as vegetable refuse, farm litter like weeds, stubble, straw, sugar cane, trash, sewage, sludge, and animal waste in homes and in area like human and industrial refuse. And the method of production of the compost is just like the FIM. Only the material is changed. And it takes also 5 to 6 months for total formation. Next, please. Green manuring. The sunhemp, dhancha, cluster bean, sage, cowpea, barseem, there are so many crops which are utilized for the green manuring, and it produces around 3 to 10 tons of the equivalent to the FIM. And these are very, they increase the porosity and texture, they improve the texture of the soil also. Therefore, it is very much essential part of the organic agriculture. Can please. Next, concentrated organic manure. The concentrated organic manures are good material that are organic in nature and contain high share of essential plant nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potash as compared to bulky organic manure. These concentrated manures are made from raw materials of animals or plant origin. The concentrated organic manures will be used as oil cake, blood meal, fish meal, meat meal, and horn and hoof meals. Next is tins. Now these are the concentrated manure, that is oil cake, blood meal, meat meal, horn meal, and fish meal. And industrial waste. Among the industrial waste, waste but is the very much important that is utilized by the farmer, and around 10 tons per hectare is recommended for the agriculture. And most of the crops, amount is good for the most of the crops, and these are utilized after the decomposition. If the fresh mud is fresh, then don't apply directly in the farm. It always apply in the farm after the decomposition. The decomposition process is very simple. first of all, you collect whole press mud in the field and cover with the crop residues, and one and a half month it open and mix the some cow dung, fresh cow dung and fresh and well fertile soil in the press mud, and again covered with the dry grasses or paddy stem, and after 2 months it fully decomposed and then applied in the field. Otherwise there are a lot of problem. Can please the earthworm excreta, the what is the vermicompost? Next is the vermicomposting. The vermicomposting is the first of all, what is the vermicompost? Vermicompost is the vermicast plus the decomposed material that is formed by the microbes, that is called the vermicompost. And vermicast is the earthworm excreta is known as the vermi. There are so many methods by which we prepare the vermicompost. There are the in situ vermicomposting, large scale vermicomposting, kitchen garden composting, and there are two or three species that is utilized for the vermicomposting. These are the Asinia podida and Lumbricus vellus, and local worm is also utilized for this purpose. And the 800 to 1000 worms is sufficient for the 1 quintal of the organic waste, and that produces around 25 kg compost per week. For the vermicomposting, it is very much essential to identify what is the liking of the earthworm, because without giving the suitable place, good food, it can't survive, or we can't get success in the vermicomposting. The first of all, the earthworm like the dark place, humid place, and eat heavy decomposed material. Therefore, it is very much essential to provide such things for the vermicomposting. इसलिए बहुत ही आवश्यक है कि जब हमें जब भी वर्मिकम्पोस्टिंग करनी है तो हम ऐसे प्लेस को रखें कि जो इन सब चीजों को पूरा करता हो. तो इसके लिए अगर हम बात करें तो सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज है किचन गार्डन मॉडल. इन किचन गार्डन मॉडल द पिट साइज इज 2 square meter और 1 square meter. इट मे बी डिपेंड अपॉन द साइज ऑफ द किचन गार्डन. एंड द फर्स्ट थिंग इज द यू प्रिपेयर ए सॉइल बेड. तो व्हाट इज सॉइल बेड या अर्थवर्म बेड? इन फॉर द अर्थवर्म बेड देर इज 1 foot. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू डिग 1 cubic meter pit, that is 1 meter depth, 1 meter width, and that may be the 2 or 1 meter length. In depth, first of all, you put the heavy gravels, heavy size gravels. Later on, you put some coarse grains, a coarse sand. Later on, you put some healthy soil. उसके बाद उसमें earthworm जो है हम रखते हैं लगभग 100 earthworm पर स्क्वायर मीटर इज रिक्वायर्ड. एंड इट प्रोड्यूसेस ये लगभग 50 टू 60 दिन में 3 times ज्यादा बढ़ जाते हैं, और ऐसी इनकी पॉपुलेशन बढ़ती रहती है. और वर्मी कंपोजिशन जब भी करते हैं तो उसमें हम 3 या 4 जगह पहले जो हमारे काउडन है उसको रखते हैं, उसके बाद अर्थवर्म डालते हैं, और फिर पुआल या ड्राई ग्रासेस से उसको कवर कर देते हैं. और जो हमारा साइड में गड्ढे किनारे हम 4 poles को रख देते हैं, उन पोल्स के ऊपर हम सब्जियों को चढ़ाते हैं. तो सब्जियां उनको शेड प्रोवाइड करती हैं, और उनकी जड़ जो है वर्मी पिट में चली जाती है, जो वर्मी कंपोस्टिंग हमारा वर्मी कंपोस्ट तैयार होता है उससे वो न्यूट्रिशन प्रोवाइड करती हैं, लेती हैं, और शेड प्रोवाइड करती है वो अर्थवर्म को, जिससे दोनों का जो है काम चलता है. और इसी बहाने जो हेल्दी फूड, जो ऑर्गेनिक फूड, जो ऑर्गेनिक वेजिटेबल हम पैदा करते हैं, ये बहुत जरूरी है कि हम अपने किचन गार्डन में इस तरह के मॉडल को डेवलप करें और फॉर द लार्ज प्रोडक्शन इट इज फॉर स्मॉल प्रोडक्शन a tank size that is 4 meter long, 1 meter width, and have the 1 meter depth is constructed with the brick line in a set place. The bottom of the tank, that is about 25 centimeter, is made up by the pieces of the brick, stone chips, and 5 centimeter sand. Thereafter, soil is spread over this to thick about 15 centimeter, and this is the total structure is called the vermi bed. And about 10 to 20 kilogram of dung and 100 number of earthworms are placed over the vermi bed. It should be moistured without flooding and covered with layer of about 10 centimeter extra leaf of the plant. Kitchen waste etc. are spread over this layer. This can be continued till the bed is completely filled. Liquid cow dung suspension is applied time to time. Watering the tank is very important till the preparation of compost, biogas slurry, supplementary waste, or any type of the plant waste can be utilized for the vermi composting. And it is very much essential you always put in the pit heavy decomposed material in huge amount. Otherwise, small amount you can add in the vermi bed. Otherwise, there is a lot of temperature rises and इसका जो हमारा पूरा का पूरा जो है वो कहीं गायब हो जाएगा. इसलिए बहुत ही आवश्यक है कि हम सेमी डीकम्पोज में डालें मटेरियल, और यदि हम फ्रेश मटेरियल डालते हैं तो हमेशा हमें ऊपर की जो एरिया है उसको पंजे से लकड़ी से उसको हमें गिराना पड़ेगा, उसको हटाना पड़ेगा ताकि उसकी हीट जो है बाहर निकले. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. एंड दिस इज द वर्मी कंपोस्टिंग बेड दैट इज prepared in the at the CISH Lucknow. Next is Nadab method. This is the developed by the farmer that is the Narayan Dev Rao Pandari Pande of the Maharashtra. This is the aerobic method of composting, and among the all Bangalore method, Coimbatore method, and I think that this is the best method for the preparing of the compost. And in this method, we can prepare by the 1 kg cow dung about 40 kg FIM. In this method has become quite popular among farmer in Western India. The Nadab method of making compost is unique not because of its successful in making good compost, which other method can also lay claim. Its real secret lies in the large quantities of compost the process can deliver with a minimum of human effort with a specific period of time. In this, a brick structure measure 10 feet length, 4 feet width, and 3 feet height is prepared, hole in the side wall to ensure adequate supply of air during composting. The brick tank is filled with farm waste, soil and cow dung, and water is added to maintain moisture between 60 to 75%. A tank is filled with approximately soil that is 0.75 quintals, farm waste 18 to 20 quintals, and fresh dung that is the 5 quintals, 0 to 0.5 quintals. Water is added to moist the material and upper layer is plastered with soil and dung mixture. After 60 days of composting, microbial culture of Azotobacter, Rhizobium and phosphate salvaging bacteria are added to the mixture. इसमें जो major things है, if you want to increase the phosphorus content, then always add 5 kg rock phosphate in every layer. In this method, the first of all we put the thick branches in lower side. After that we put on the dry matter like poal and dry grasses, and some and about 6 to 4 inch the green grasses. It may be the green leaves, green grasses, or any green material. And उसके ऊपर जो हमें हल्का हल्का 20% जो स्लरी है गोबर की काउडन उसको हमें स्प्रे करना चाहिए. फिर मिट्टी लगभग 1 सेंटीमीटर मोटी उसके ऊपर जो मिट्टी वहाँ की होनी चाहिए जो हमें प्लांट के नीचे की हो. वो प्लांट बनियान ट्री है. बनियान ट्री के नीचे मैक्सिमम हमारे माइक्रोब्स पाए जाते हैं. वो माइक्रोब जो कि हमारे हेल्पफुल हैं उनको हमें उस में ऐड करना चाहिए. दैट इज 1 सेंटीमीटर. लेटर ऑन इन सेकेंड लेयर फिर सूखी घास फिर ग्रीन जो ग्रासेस है उनको ऐड करना चाहिए. उसके ऊपर फिर 20% जो स्लरी है काउडंग की उसको स्प्रे करना चाहिए और फिर मिट्टी डालना चाहिए. ऐसे करते हुए 5 लेयर्स में हमारा पूरा जो टैंक है जाता है. और यदि हमें फास्फोटिक फर्टिलाइजर को इंक्रीज करना है तो रॉक फास्फेट को प्रत्येक लेयर में लगभग 5 kg उसमें डालना है, जिससे 25 kg 30 kg हम रॉक फास्फेट ऐड कर सकते हैं. और जब भी हमें इनाकुलेशन करना हो एजेटोबैक्टर का, राइजोबियम का या किसी अन्य माइक्रोब्स का, तो हमें इसमें ड्रेंजिंग करनी होती है. वो 2 महीने के बाद जब 2 महीने का पिट जब पूरा पिट हमारे भर जाता है तो लास्ट जो लेयर है पूरे टाइम को हम लगभग 1 फीट से 1.5 फीट ऊपर तक भरते हैं और उसको गोबर और मिट्टी की सलरी से पूरा प्लास्टरिंग कर देते हैं. और प्लास्टरिंग के बाद 2 महीने बाद हम इसमें फिर होल करके इन माइक्रोब्स को पानी में घोल करके जिसमें 2 to 5% जगरी का सिरप हो उसको डाल करके फिर होल को बंद कर देते हैं. और आफ्टर 3 मंथ जो पूरा हमारा 3 to 4 मंथ में पूरी हमारी खाद तैयार हो जाती है और इसमें जितनी भी हमारे प्लांट के सीड्स हैं वो सभी डिकम्पोज हो जाते हैं. तो सबसे बड़ा फायदा यह है कि इससे कोई भी हमारी वीट की समस्या नहीं रहती है और बहुत कम टाइम में हमारी खाद तैयार हो जाती है. दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल बाई दर एनरोबिक मेथड ऑफ द कंपोस्टिंग. नेक्स्ट प्लीज. This is the indoor method. So in indoor method, the major difference between the indoor method and this in indoor method is developed by the Howard and Ward in 1931. In indoor method, there are 5 to 6 trenches. In जो 5 trenches है उसमें हम organic waste को layer by layer जैसे हमने native composting में fill up किया वैसे भरते जाते हैं. और उसी तरीके से इसमें मिट्टी और जो काउडंग की स्लरी है उसको भी हम डालते जाते हैं और जो लास्ट हमारा जो ट्रेंच होता है उसको खुला छोड़ते हैं. और इसमें जो मेन प्रोसेस जो चेंज करने का है टर्निंग प्रोसेस, दैट इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट. द फर्स्ट टर्निंग हमें 15 डेज में करनी होती है, सेकेंड टर्निंग हमें 60 डेज में करनी होती है, थर्ड टर्निंग जो है सेकेंड टर्निंग जो हमें 15, 13, 60 डेज में करते हैं. फर्स्ट टर्निंग इज आफ्टर 15 डेज, सेकेंड टर्निंग इज आफ्टर 30 डेज, एंड थर्ड टर्निंग इज आफ्टर 60 डेज, एंड फोर्थ टर्निंग मीन्स 90 डेज पे ही हमारा पूरा खाद तैयार हो जाता है. तो टोटल मेथड इज एरोबिक मेथड एंड दिस मेथड इज ऑल्सो वेरी मच पॉपुलर एमंग द फार्मर एंड दिस इज वेरी गुड फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिक मेन्योर by the organic waste of the farm and also the farmer can utilize this technique by farming the decomposition of the organic waste. And this compost contains at least 0.8% nitrogen, 0.3% phosphorus and 1.5% of the potash. Next please. And this is the structure of the and composting, indoor method of composting. Just 6 feet is the bucket and 1, 2, 3, 4 is filled with the organic matter. After 15 days the whole material is diverted in the sixth. The fifth is जो पांचवा हमारा जो कंपोस्ट पीट है उसको हम सिक्स में ऐड करते हैं और फोर्थ को फिफ्थ में, थ्री को फोर्थ में, टू को थ्री में एंड वन को टू में. तो लास्ट वन जो हमारा खाली पड़ा रहता है. फिर आफ्टर 30 डेज टू को वन में डालते हैं, थ्री को टू में, फोर को थ्री में और सिक्स को फाइव में. आफ्टर 60 डेज अगेन रिवर्स होता है, वन को टू में, टू को थ्री में. इस तरीके से हमारा 90 डेज में ये पूरा हमारा तैयार हो जाता है. नेक्स्ट, बैंगलोर मेथड. दिस इज द एनएरोबिक मेथड ऑफ द कंपोस्टिंग एंड ये वहां पे डेवलप किया गया जहां पे शहर के बाहर, जब हमारा ऑर्गेनिक जितना सिटी वेस्ट है, ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट, उसको हम डीकम्पोज करने के लिए ये मेथड को डेवलप किया गया. इसमें जो टोटल जो साइज हमारी पिट की है वो डिपेंड करती है हमारी आवश्यकता के अनुरूप. वो कभी भी साइज 1 meter, से मेन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज द डेप्थ शुड बी नॉट मोर देन 1 meter एंड वेथ शुड बी 1.25 meter टू 1 meter एंड लेंथ वेरिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू रिक्वायरमेंट. द होल पिट इज फिल्ड विद द ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट एंड कवर्ड एंड व्हेन इट फिल्ड एंड लगभग 15 दिन में पूरा जो हमारा फिलअप हो जाना चाहिए. और फिलअप होने के बाद टोटल जो है जो हेल्दी सॉइल है उससे प्लास्टिंग कर देते हैं और ऐसी और इसको 15 डेज तक, सॉरी इसको 4 मंथ तक वैसे ही छोड़ते हैं. आफ्टर 4 मंथ इस पूरे मटेरियल को एक जगह निकाल के रख देते हैं और लगभग इट टेक्स 6 to 7 months फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द होल FIM फॉर होल कंपोस्ट. द टोटल जो हमारी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दिस इज द एनोरोबिक मेथड ऑफ द कंपोस्टिंग. इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ टाइम, इट मे बी 6 to 7 months. Therefore, it is not better than the desert composting, a Bangalore method of the composting. Next, please. The biofertilizer, the rhizobium that that incorporate the nitrogen 50 to 100 kg per hectare in the soil, as per the last about 20 to 40 kg per hectare in the soil, Azotobacter 20 kg per hectare in the soil. It increase the uptake of Azotobacter, also increase the nitrogen, phosphorus, iron and zinc in the soil and produces oxygen, gibberellic acid and vitamin B also. That is very much helpful for the growth of the plant. BG and Azora is also utilized as the biofertilizer that incorporate in the field, that is 20 to 30 kg per nitrogen per hectare in nitrogen in the field. Phosphorus salvaging microalgae, that is Pseudomonas, that salvage phosphorus, that is very much helpful to the plant. A zinc stabilizing, that is Rhizobium, Aspergillum, Azotobacter, this is also very good biofertilizer and utilized by the farmer. The mycorrhizae, this is also stabilize, that makes the complex form of the phosphorus, calcium, copper, zinc and so many minerals in the simple form, available form to the plant. And Trichoderma, this is the biocontrol fungi for the soil borne diseases. These all micro fertilizers, biofertilizers can be inoculated in the FIM just after 2 months after decomposition by drenching method. And later on, it ये पूरा हमारा जो माइक्रोब्स है वो पूरे हमारी FIM में फैल जाएगा. और इस प्रकार से जब इस तरह की FIM को फील्ड में इस्तेमाल करेंगे तो दो ज़्यादा फायदेमंद होगा. यदि हम सीधे राइजोबियम को फील्ड में इस्तेमाल करते हैं तो वो सीधे जो गर्मी हमारी धूप की या फिर बहुत कोल्ड वेदर है उसमें सर्वाइव नहीं करता, उसको ऑर्गेनिक जो कार्बन है वो नहीं मिलता है, इससे ये पूरी इसकी जो ग्रोथ है वो कम हो जाती है, उनकी पॉपुलेशन कम हो जाती है. यदि हम ये ऑर्गेनिक मैटर के साथ जब हम फील्ड में डालते हैं तो इनकी संख्या बढ़ जाती है और ये मल्टीप्लाई हो जाती है जो हमारा ऑर्गेनिक मैन्योर से बहुत ज्यादा संख्या में, उससे ये प्लांट के लिए बहुत ही हेल्पफुल है। कभी बायो फर्टिलाइजर को सिंपली के बजाय हम इसको ऑर्गेनिक मैन्योर में हमेशा जब 2 महीने की खाद हमारी तैयार हो जाए उसके बाद ही डालना चाहिए, अदरवाइज इनकी पॉपुलेशन नहीं बढ़ सकती है। ये ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट। और जब भी हम डालते हैं तो इसको सीरप में, जगरी का सीरप जो है बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है जिसमें, या शुगर जो है कभी ठीक नहीं होता लेकिन जगरी मिले तो उसका इस्तेमाल करना चाहिए इसको डालने के लिए। नेक्स्ट प्लीज। रोल ऑफ बायो फर्टिलाइजर इन एग्रीकल्चर। द यूज ऑफ बायो फर्टिलाइजर प्लेज मेजर रोल इन इम्प्रूविंग सॉइल फर्टिलिटी, इल एट्रीब्यूटिंग कैरेक्टर्स and thereby final yield has been reported by many workers. In addition, their application in soil improves soil biota and minimizes the sole use of chemical fertilizer. They play other various roles in agriculture. Improved nutrient uptake, that is micro and micronutrients, better water relation and drought tolerant, soil structure, enhanced polyphytohormone activity, and crop protection also in disease by the so many pathogens that is found in the soil like trichoderma. Next please. Bioenhancers. The bioenhancers are organic preparations obtained by active fermentation of animal and plant residues over a specific duration. These are rich source of microbial constituents, micronutrients and plant growth promoting substances including immunity enhancer. In general, these are utilized to treat seeds and seedlings also. It enhances decomposition of organic material, thereby enrich soil and induce better plant vigor. Characteristic of the bioenhancer: potent source for micro and micronutrients, presence of plant growth promoting factors, immunity enhancer, pesticide and fungicidal property. Efficiency is influenced by input use and method of preparation. Used for seed and seedling treatment, enhancing decomposition, improving soil fertility and productivity, and efficient and potent tools for fertigation. Next please. And the first bioenhancer is the Amrit Mitti. For the Amrit Mitti, the first of all we prepare Amrit Jal, and the process of the preparing of the Amrit Jal, preparing of the heap, greening of the heap, and care of the heap. These are the 4 things which are utilized by the Amrit Pani. The Amrit Jal is made by the cow urine, 1 kg of cow dung, 50 gram of the black jaggery or 12 banana, sugar cane juice, mahua, that is Madhuka latifolia flower, or cashew apple, is mixed and diluted with 100 liter of water. And the preparation technique is: the compost heap size of 10 feet long, 3 feet wide, and 1 meter is prepared on ground where water logging does not occur during the rainy season. For one heap, one average 400 to 600 liter of Amrit Pani, the Amrit Jal is required. Locally available organic waste, that is living straw, grasses, fodder, waste, lawn, clipping, etc., are cut into small pieces and soaked for 24 hours in Amrit Jal. Alternate layers is scraped ground soil and organic waste are piled. 300 ground seed of various crops, that is grain of the pulses, oil seeds, spices, vegetable, root crop, herbal and medicinal plant are grown over the dry surface. The better germination, take ground seed to be sown per square feet. It is pertinent to regard that besides the biodiversity, there is considerable variation in the availability of nutrients in different stages of the plant foliage as summarized below. Because the जो भी हमारे ये जो प्लांट्स हैं जो डिफरेंट ऑयल सीड स्पाइसेस वेजिटेबल जब उनके ऊपर ग्रो करते हैं तो जो टेंडर पार्ट उसका है दैट कंटेन्स जिंक फॉस्फेट बोरान एंड मॉलिब्डेनम एंड ग्रीन मैच्योर लीव दैट इज रिच इन द नाइट्रोजन मैग्नीशियम एंड पोटेशियम एंड ड्राई लीव आर रिच इन द कैल्शियम सिल्का बोरान आयरन एंड मैंगनीज. तो ये पूरी जो इसमें बनाने का जो बेस्ट मेथड है उसको जितनी भी हमारी ऑर्गेनिक हर्ब्स हैं उनको हम छोटे छोटे टुकड़ों में काट लेते हैं काटने के बाद 400 टू 600 लीटर अमृत जल से उसको सेचुरेट कर लेते हैं. इसके बाद जो हमारे डिफरेंट टाइप की हर्ब्स हैं ऑयल सीड स्पाइसेस वेजिटेबल उनके ऊपर हम इसको ग्रो कर देते हैं. जब ये पौधे बड़े हो जाए तो 21 डेज आफ्टर 25% पोर्शन को हम कट बैक कर देते हैं और उसमें मिक्स कर देते हैं. लेटर ऑन आफ्टर 42 डेज द अपर पोर्शन ऑफ द 25% पार्ट उसको हम फिर अगेन उसको कट करके मिक्स कर देते हैं एंड रिस्ट ऑफ द प्लांट पार्ट इज कन्वर्टेड आफ्टर 63 डेज आफ्टर लिविंग द वन एंड हाफ इंच ऑफ द पोर्शन. और टोटल इस पूरे कटिंग्स को इन हर्ब्स के साथ मिक्स कर देते हैं और ये पूरा 140 डेज के बाद हमारा टोटल बायोमास डिकम्पोज हो जाता है एंड दिस इज वेरी गुड फॉर द ग्रोइंग ऑफ द क्रॉप्स एंड वेरी रिच इन द सो मेनी हार्मोन्स बैक्टीरिया एंड एंजाइम्स. द साइंटिस्ट स्टडी सिंपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट लेयर ऑफ द हीप एंड रिपोर्टेड highest amount of available phosphorus, total phosphorus, available nitrogen, transferable potash, organic carbon. They remarked that the some samples of the Amrit Bitti had up to 100 million plant growth promoting bacteria in every gram of the compost, highest ever measured in any compost. This is the main benefit of the Amrit Jal. Next, please. The panchagavya that is made by the cow dung, cow urine, cow milk, and cow milk curd, and cow ghee that is included for the specific duration in earthen or wider mouth plastic container. When these are properly mixed, incubate for recommended period and ready fermented solution for meticulous check on the crop. Next, please. The panchagavya is now gaining attention as an efficient organic growth promoter. Composition of the panchagavya contains aerobic heterophyllic bacteria, lactic acid bacteria, yeast, fungi, photosynthetic bacteria, and anaerobic bacteria. The highest microbial load was recorded in 7 days old preparation, though a gradual reduction in the microbial load was observed up to 50 days. And population reduced significantly after 30 days. The preparation is rich in almost all micro and micronutrients, oxygen, gibberellins, and microbial fauna, and acts as tonic to enrich the soil to induce plant vigor with quality production. Its remarkable effect has been demonstrated in fruits like mango, guava, acid lime, banana, spices. Like turmeric, flower like jasmine, tuberose, gladiolus, and vegetables such as the cucumber, spinach, etc. Can please. And this is the flow sheet for the preparation of the panchagavya. First of all, thoroughly mix the cow dung and cow ghee, and incubate for the 2 days. Then again add urine plus 10 liter of water. And stir properly in morning and evening, and left for incubation for 15 days. And add sugar cane juice, then add cow milk, and cow curd. And later on, cow water, that coconut water is added, or if the coconut water is not available, then banana is added and incubate for the 2 weeks. Next, please. Jeevamrit. Jeevamrit is prepared by the fermenting cow dung, urine, jaggery, that is the cow urine, jaggery, corn flour, and virgin soil of the simple facilities created in the village with minimum expenditure. This is developed by the Mr. Paletar, and he is the strong follower of the natural farming. It can be used at 15 to 13 days interval for irrigation water, coupled with the mulching, green or dye, monocot and die cut, and proper soil aeration. Jeevamrit is rich bioformulation, contains pastoria of beneficial microbes. This formulation is used within 3 to 7 days of preparation. 200 liter of Jeevamrit is enough for 1 acre of crop area. In general, 2 to 3 times application during the crop period is recommended. It can be drenched
Hello. So, are you facing any problem?
It can be drained on mulch either by deep irrigation or through spraying. It is also effective in quick decomposition of crop residues if applied with irrigation water given for the field preparation. With micro irrigation, 3 to 4 times more area can be covered with 200 liters of Jeevamrit. Next, please. Amrit Pani. It is a special bioformulation rich in nutrients and beneficial microbes. Ingredients for preparation of Amrit Pani and its intensive use were advocated by different scientists. It is used to improve seed germination, soil fertility, and plant vigor. It is prepared from the cow dung, cow ghee, and honey as summarized below. The cow dung is 10 kg, cow ghee 250 gram and honey 500 gram. Next, please. Preparation method is 10 kg of fresh cow dung is mixed for 2 hours with 250 gram cow ghee. After proper mixing and 250 gram honey diluted to the tune of 200 liter of and mixed thoroughly for 4 hours. This preparation is known as the Amrit Pani. Preparation is ready for use after 1 week incubation. This is used for number of preparations such as Bhumi Sanskar, that is a soil treatment. After incubation, it is spread on prepared field, ready for the sowing or transplanting. 500 liter of Amrit Pani is sufficient for 1 hectare of the land. Second one is the seed treatment, that is the Bhumi Sanskar. Soak seed in the Amrit Pani and dry under shade before sowing. For the hard core, soak the seed in Gomutra before treating with Amrit Pani for 12 hours. And third one is the spraying on the crop, that is the Vanaspati Sanskar. Vanaspati Sanskar is done with the plant for maintaining crop health and getting high yield, wherein 10 liter cow urine of the indigenous cow is mixed with 2 liter of neem oil and 200 liter of the water. This mixture is spread on 1 hectare of the land. Next, please. Use of the Amrit Pani in agriculture. The dressing of seed with hardwood such as rice, wheat, corn and okra take 1 kilo of angara. Angara is the soil that is found from the root zone of the banyan tree that is added sufficient in the amritpani to make a thick paste or mud. Mix a small quantity of paste with the seed in a sifting pan and keep it rotating till seeds are covered with mud. Dry tea seeds instead store and use as need. But for the soft coated seed, the sprinkling of the amritpani is required before sowing the seed, and just after sprinkling the immediately sow the seed. For the sugarcane, the whole rhizome, a whole cutting should be dipped in the amritpani before transplanting, and seedling before transplanting should be dipped like rice vegetables in amritpani can be mixed with irrigation water through the flow or drip irrigation. Next, please. Biodigester extract. The extract is prepared by forming. The extract is prepared by the fermenting crushed leaf of the plant along with the cow dung and urine in a plastic container of the suitable size, known as the biodigester. In general, green leaves of the neem, Calotropis vitex, Adoptera, Ipomium, Custard apple, and Agave. 5 kilograms of the each leaves are mixed with little soil and 200 liters of water. The mixture is stirred twice a day and get ready for the use in 3 weeks. Presence of naturally occurring beneficial microorganism, predominantly bacteria, actinomyces, yeast, photosynthetic bacteria, and certain fungi are the major strength of these bio enhancers. Next, please. The microbe load of the different bio enhancers. As per concern of the bacteria, the panchagarbh contains more number of the bacteria in comparison to jeevamrit, bijamrit, and biogas slurry. And fungi also more number are found in the panchagarbh as compared to the jeevamrit, bijamrit, and biogas. And actinomyces are found more number in the jeevamrit in compared to the panchagarbh, bijamrit, and phosphorus solubilizing bacteria are found more number in the jeevamrit, whereas the living organism found in the panchagarbh, more number of the filium bacteria, phytoorganism are found in the panchagarbh, and nitrogen fixer bacteria are found, microorganism are found in the bijamrit. These are shows the importance of the bioenhancer that is rich in the bacteria, fungi, actinomycetes, phosphorus fertilizer, free living organism, and nitrogen fixer. They are very much helpful for the production of the plants, as well as it also recycle the whole organic waste into it and also act as a decomposer. The all bacteria, fungi, actinomyces, phosphorus fertilizer bacteria, free living organism, and nitrogen fixer microorganisms, these all are converted, all the waste material into the organic decomposed material. Therefore, these bioenhancers are very much important for the farmers. Next, please. Nutrient status of the different organic liquid manure. In panchagarbh, the total nitrogen was found in more, in the total nitrogen was found in high amount in the jeevamrit, and the total potassium in the jeevamrit, whereas the zinc copper, iron, total manganese are found in the Bija Amrita. These table also shows these lichen manure bioenhancer are also rich in the nitrogen and minerals. Therefore, these are very much beneficial for the growing of the crop. They are very much helpful for the farmers, and they can make in their field, in their house, without any difficulties, and these are the very much beneficial for the crop also. Thank you. Next, Vermi wash is also a bioenhancer. It is liquid lechen obtained by the excess water to saturate the vermicompost substrate. It is collection of the excretory products of mucus, nutrients of the earthworm, along with the nutrients from the soil organic molecules. In fact, vermi wash is in this bioenhancer prepared from the heavy population of the earthworm reared in the earthen pots, oblique plastic pots, or cement container. It contains hormones like the gibberellin, cytokinin, secreted by the earthworm. The vermi wash microflora contains azotobacter, agrobacterium, rhizobium, and phosphate salvaging microbes. Presence of these microbes make available inorganic nitrogen, ammonia, amino acids, and inorganic phosphate to plant, so ammonification and nitrification process. Besides these vermi wash contains total heterophyllus, that is the nitrosoma, nitrobacter, and total fungi. Vermi wash can be used for better growth, yield, and quality production. Recently, microbial study of the vermi wash revealed that it contains nitrogen fixing bacteria like azotobacter, agrobacterium species, rhizobium species, and phosphate salvaging bacteria. Next, please. Protease in the soil helps in seed germination, while amylase helps in the availability of simple carbon source for enhancement of the plant vigor and productivity. Soil-bound microflora is essential for the growth of the plant because organic nitrogen compounds and phosphorus are decomposed and mineralized by mixing and phosphate salvaging bacteria. Presence of large number of beneficial microorganisms helps in plant growth and protects from a number of pathogens in the field. Repeated spray of vermi wash has been found effective even management of thrips and mites in chili. In our condition, we have grown the papaya plant in our orchard and sprayed the vermi wash at the 10 or 7 days interval and found that the total plant was free from the leaf curl disease, whereas the control condition 25 to 30% plants are affected by the leaf curl disease. Therefore, you can say this is the very much very important for the farmers. And if needed, vermi wash may be mixed with the cow urine, and that is the ratio of the 1:1:8 ratio: vermi wash, cow urine, and water. And used as foliar spray for nutrients and pesticidal properties. It gets diluted in the water, 1:5 or 1:10 ratio, can be used as a foliar spray for any crop. Its impact is better than chemical fertilizer in a comparative study. Next, please. And this is the technique for the making of vermi wash. In vermi composting, we added so many organic herbs, but in case of the vermi wash, we are only utilize the cow dung and cow urine for the preparing of the vermi wash. The vermi bed is just like the vermi composting, like the lower surface is the stone that is around 6 inches, and after that the coarse sand, and after that we add the soil that is around the 6 to 8 inches. Later on the earthworm is added and the cow dung is also added. The total जो इसमें हमारी पूरी जो अर्थवर्म वर्मी वास बनाने के तरीके हैं, इसमें सबसे पहले 15 दिन के लिए हम इसका जो आउटलेट है उसको ओपन कर देते हैं और धीरे धीरे इसमें वाटर को ऐड करते हैं और मॉइस्चर मेंटेन किए रहते हैं। 15 दिन तक जो भी पानी हमारा आता है उसको आउटलेट से निकाल देते हैं। आफ्टर 15 डेज हम आउटलेट को बंद कर देते हैं और अर्थवर्म जो हमारा एक्टिव हो जाता है और जितना बायोलिशन स्टार्ट कर देता है उस समय हम जस्ट आफ्टर 30 डेज इट अगेन ओपन फॉर द कलेक्शन ऑफ द वर्मी वॉश एंड दिस इज वेरी मच बेनिफिशियल फॉर द फार्मर एंड कैन बी स्प्रे आफ्टर डाइल्यूशन 1:7 या 1:10 इन द टिश्यू ओवर द प्लांट। नेक्स्ट डे बाय एनहांसर विद अग्निहोत्र इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ हार्नेसिंग कॉस्मिक एनर्जी थ्रू साइंस ऑफ पिरामिडोलॉजी बायोरिथम ऑफ नेचर सनराइज एंड सनसेट सोनिक एनर्जी साइंस ऑफ द वाइब्रेशन ऑफ स्पेसिफिक मंत्रास बर्निंग ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस आर डेली इम्प्लाइड and energized through evaporation and its impact is extended in given area through establishment of the resonance point. Agnihotra as was found to be rich source of organic carbon, phosphorus, sulfur, potassium, calcium, magnesium, iron, manganese, copper and zinc. The application of Agnihotra S, that is 3.5 milligram per plant, exists in the soil just at the time of transplanting, and its further supplementation in the soil at drench at a regular interval of 15 days was found most stable for controlling the foot borer and shoe borer. And it is also applied, it can also apply it in the any crop. It improves the green color in the plant. It also improves the coloration in the so many ornamental plants as well as in the vegetable plants. Therefore, by the Agnihotra S can be utilized as a bio enhancer for the production of the crop. Next, please. Okay. Use of the Agnihotra S. Agnihotra S is a powerful input to organic farmer as potent source of the energy and therapeutic values. Agnihotra S enriched water, biosol, a potent bioenhancer. These are used in the following manner: to store seed, to teach seed planting material before sowing the planting, to enhance soil fertility, to teach water bodies for improving its quality and availability, to enhance soil fertility and plant vigor, to manage pests and diseases, to improve production and quality of produce, to enhance efficiency of compost, bioenhancers and biopesticides. Mix Agnihotra S with grains and seed before their storage. It keeps the attack of pests at zero level. The grain can be used either for human consumption or as seed. 1 kg Agnihotra S is spread over 1 acre of land before crop sowing or planting. The S not only helps to maintain soil fertility but also energize the soil, imparting subtle energies that add in plant growth. Next, please. Biodynamic farming. It is the award native by the Dr. Rudolf Steiner and one of my colleague Dr. Ram Wal explain this technology in the next lecture. Next please. Effect of the organic nutrition on the crop productivity. It has been seen in the so many crops that the organic nutrition increase the productivity of the so many crops instead in comparison to the organic farming, inorganic farming. By the likewise, the application of the organic material increase the grain and starch yield of the rice. The application of spent mushroom and rice starch compost to the comparable in the FOM increase the rice grain yield by the 20% over the NPK fertilizer. All of the yield attributes characters of the rice increase with increasing rates of FOM. Organic farming with dhancha made considerable improvement in the grain yield of the rice and chickpea. Next. Vegetables are highly responsive to organic source of the nutrient and profitable to the farmers. Vermicompost application of 15 kg per square meter gave the highest yield in the tomato crop. A significant higher yield of the sweet pepper with vermicompost was also reported. Next please. Total potato tubers yield was significantly higher with the application of vermicompost, that is 4 ton per hectare and FOM at 25 ton per hectare. Tubers from the organic potato cropping contain sufficient high tuber dry matter concentration that is good for the French fries. Next please. A significant increase yield by application of vermicompost at 13 to 20 quintal per hectare in pea and groundnut was recorded. The seed yield of the sunflower was increased with the vermicompost that is 10 ton per hectare. Next please. The state-wise distribution of the soil nutrient, which has been observed that in the state Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Delhi, Gujarat, Jharkhand, Manipur and Telangana. In six states, there are increase in the so many nutrients, whereas in another 2015 to 17 and 17 to 19. In case of Andhra Pradesh, within 2 years, the boron, iron was increased, that is, come into lower group to the medium group, and potash comes in the high level of the group. In Bihar, the total copper, manganese, sulfur and zinc increase from lower to medium group, and in Delhi the organic carbon, iron and manganese increase, and that comes in the medium group from the lower group. And whereas the potassium increase that comes in the higher group. In Jharkhand, the sulfur and zinc increases and comes in the medium group from the lower group. And in Manipur, the iron and manganese increases that comes in the medium group from the lower group. And organic carbon are highly increases, and that is coming from medium to high group. Whereas the Telangana, the phosphorus, boron, copper, manganese and sulfur increases in the soil, and that comes in the medium group from the lower group. But in the rest of the state, there is about no increase in the these micro and micronutrients. Therefore, you can say the state simply changed. Therefore, we can say the state which are utilized more number of the organic matter they are in these soils, increasing their nutrient, and where they are utilizing the inorganic salt, organic matter, there is no increase in the nutrients as well as the organic matter. Thank you. Can please next. And these are states where though nothing has been found in, but in six states there is change in the nutrient status. Can please next. The biomass production and nutrient accumulated by the bean manure. When you talk about the nutrient status of the different crop that is utilized by the, that is for the bean manuring, the more nutrients was found in Echinocrona species that contains 70 quintal per hectare dry matter, nitrogen 198, and among the all green manure crops, this crop contains more number of the nutrients as well as the dry matter. Whereas the Sesbania is on the second highest list, that contains 50 quintal of the organic matter and contains more number of phosphorus, potassium, zinc, manganese, iron, copper and manganese. Therefore, we can say Echinocrona species is the best for the green manuring, followed by the Sesbania rostrata, and even the Congress grass is also contain the good amount of the nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, zinc, iron, copper and manganese, and have also contain the 40 quintal per hectare of the organic matter. Next please. These are the list of the NPK content that is found in the different organic manure. The CUN contains more number of the nitrogen and potash, and this urine is best for the spring as well as formation of the so many compost. The rural compost contains the low number of the nitrogen, phosphorus and potash, whereas the urban compost contain more number of the nitrogen, phosphorus and potash, more content, that is 7 to 2%, and phosphoric acid is 0.9 to 3%, and potash is 1 to 2%. Whereas the agriculture residue is concerned, the PNP contains more percentage of the nitrogen, and maize contains more phosphoric acid and potash. PNP contains more potash and nitrogen compound. Therefore, these crops are good for rich in the nitrogen and potassic fertilizer, and can be utilized as the green manure, and can be reutilized, decomposed in the soil, and they increase the fertility of the soil instead of the other crops. Whereas wheat contains 0.53% of the nitrogen, and phosphoric acid is 0.1%, and potash is 1.1%. And sugar cane produces 0.35% nitrogen, 0.1% phosphoric acid, and 0.6% of the potash. The total table shows that if you If you decompose these planting materials, they increase the quality of the FYM and incorporate the nutrient in the soil that is beneficial for the growth of the plant as well as the farmers. Next please. This is table shows the NPK content in the tea level and liter manure. Among the all plants, Pongamia contains more percentage of nitrogen, phosphoric acid and potash. Thus, this tea can be grown around the garden. This is the ornamental rhododendron and contains more number of nitrogen, phosphoric and potash. And if these plants are grown around the orchard or roadside avenues, then its leaves provide the more nutrients to the soil instead of the other plant. The same second number, that the Terminalia paniculata also contains more percentage of the nitrogen, and the Delenia pentingiana contains 3.2% of the potash. But this table shows there are so many trees that leaves can be utilized for the making of the manure, and they incorporate the nutrients in the soil. Next please. The NPK content in the green manure and oil cake. Among the cake, the maximum percentage of the nitrogen phosphorus was found in the sesame cake, followed by the groundnut cake. The groundnut cake contains more percentage of nitrogen, followed by the sesame cake, and sunflower and neem cake also contains maximum nitrogen content, whereas the other cakes also rich in the NPK content. Therefore, these cakes are utilized for the making of the composting, and they can incorporate the maximum number of nutrients, whereas the cowpea and most of the green manure crop also contain so many nitrogen, phosphorus, potash and minerals that is beneficial for the farmers if we utilize as a green manure. Next please. In whole sense, a thin layer of soil covering the surface of the earth is the major interface between the agriculture and the environment, and the present this difference between the survival and extinction for the most land-based life that is driven by the J.W. Duran. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your valuable time. Now we will start the question session. So you all are requested to please write your questions in chat box. We have some questions from YouTube live stream. Now I hand over Dr. Sandeep for the question session.
Dr. No, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
So lots of questions from participant sites, but some questions are selected. First question is, what is zero budget farming?
In zero budget farming, we are utilizing all the things which are prepared in the field. They give amrit pani. These are utilized in the zero budget farming.
Okay, sir. Then next question is, when use of FYM, termite is always is main problem. How to control termite in organic farming?
Actually, the major thing is the termite eat the semi-decomposed material. It does not eat the fully decomposed material. Therefore, always apply in the field fully decomposed material. If you apply the vermicompost is fully decomposed. And nether compost, the farmer manure that is fully decomposed, there is no problem of the termites. Therefore, you always suggest to the farmer to apply fully
decomposed. Okay, sir. Next question is, any model which can recommended in urban household?
In urban household, the vermicompost is a very good model. And in kitchen garden, even in the upper side of the floor, roof, they can prepare the vermicomposting, vermivore component. These methods can be applied in urban area.
Okay, sir. How can manage nutrient management in standing crop?
In which crop?
How can manage nutrient manage in standing crop?
Okay. The foliar application, as I have suggested to so many bioenhancers, that is very much beneficial for the providing the nutrients in the standing crop. Because the organic matter does not directly incorporate the nutrient to the crop. Yes. Releases the slowly by slowly and nutrient to the plant. Therefore, always the spraying of the bioenhancer and spraying of the gomutra, spraying of the jivamrita, amrita pani, and homa, they directly provide the nutrient to the plant.
So, last question is, any subsidy provided by government for organic farmer?
The central government as well as the state government provide the so many facilities to the farmer. So the that is the central government scheme. Already this scheme is launched by the central and state government.
Okay, sir. Then mic over to Dr. Dilip.
Thank you, sir. Once again, thank you to Professor Sanjay Pathak, sir, and all the participants. The evening session will be start at 4 p.m. today, and in the evening session, our speaker is Dr. M. Mohanty, Principal Scientist from Indian Institute of Soil Science, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, and his topic for talk is issues and challenges of nutrient management in organic farming. Once again, sir, thank you to you and all the participants, and big thanks to our system administrator, Mr. Lalit Joshi, sir, for all the technical support. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Sir, ek minute. Actually, National Horticulture Mission, uske dwara jo organic farming mein subsidies hain, they are provided by the National Horticulture Mission.
Okay. Thank